Amen. The second chapter. Amen. We're going to read the first verse and then we're going to skip on down from verse 9 to 13. Amen. Again, Joshua, the second chapter, the first verse, and then verses 9 through 13. Amen. We are reading from the King James Version of the Bible. And that version of the Bible goes like this. It says, and Joshua, the son of Nun, sent out two men to spy secretly, saying, go view the land, even Jericho. And they went and came to an harlot's house named Rahab, right, and lodged there. On down to the ninth verse, it says, and she said unto the men, I know that the Lord has given you land, and that your terror is fallen upon us, and that all of the inhabitants of the land faint because of you. For we have heard how the Lord dried up the water of the Red Sea for you when ye came out of Egypt, and what ye did unto the two kings of the Amorites that were of the other side of Jordan, Shion and Og, whom ye utterly destroyed. And as soon as we had heard these things, our hearts did melt. Neither did there remain any more courage in any man because of you. For the Lord your God, he is God in heaven above and in beneath. Now therefore I pray you, swear to me by the Lord, since I have shown you kindness, that you will also show kindness unto my father's house, and give me a true token, and that ye will save alive my father and my mother and my brethren and my sisters and all that they have, and deliver our lives from death. Amen. And the word of the Lord is blessed. And then the subject on today is recognizing the shift, preparing for the change. Again, we're going to recognize the shift, and we're going to prepare for the change. In my reading, I introduced to the audience three people. I introduced Joshua, I introduced spies, and I introduced Rahab. Amen. For those of you who are Bible scholars and Bible people, amen, you sort of know the story, but there may be somebody in the room, amen, that don't know, amen, the history of who I'm talking about and what has transpired up until this point. So I'm going to do a little Bible class, Sunday School 101. In Genesis, the 12th chapter, in the first verse, a God told Abram, he said, come out from among them. He said, I'm going to show you a land flowing with milk and honey. And Abram took his family, and they went on out, and they journeyed. Amen. And through trials, through tribulations, through this and that and the other. Amen. God changed Abram's name to Abraham and Sarai's name to Sarah. Amen. And Sarah had an idea, amen, that she would help God out. You know, they had promised, he had promised them that they were going to be he was going to be a father of many nations. And so she tried to help him out, and he had Ishmael, and of course we know that didn't work out. And so 10 years later, God came back to him and they said, listen, I promise you, I'm going to make you a father of many nations. And so Sarah and Abraham got together, and they had